In this video from D4Therapy, we will learn about separation anxiety in 5 minutes or less. We will go over the diagnostic criteria A to D and what is the major theme of the anxiety that separates it from other types of anxiety disorder symptoms. So let's jump right in. Criteria A is the criteria for all the symptoms that manifest when someone is dealing with separation anxiety. I have divided them into symptoms of thoughts or cognition and symptoms of behavior and physical symptoms. So thoughts and cognition can look like the person experiencing excessive distress when they anticipate separation, a worry about losing the major attachment figure, and that something bad is going to happen, like either to them or the attachment figure, like getting into a car accident or getting kidnapped. The behavior usually mirrors avoidance behavior. So they are trying to avoid separation. So they will refuse to go out or go away from home or go to work. There is a reluctance or fear of being alone. They don't want to be left alone. They don't want to sleep away from the attachment figure. They kind of constantly complain about physically, like not feeling well, usually around anticipated separation. And there might be nightmare that involves themes of separation. And if a person has 3 of these following 8 symptoms, then they probably have the diagnosis of separation anxiety. The time or the duration for the symptom is at least 1 month or 4 weeks for kids and adolescents, and at least 6 months or more for adults. Criteria C states that the disturbance should cause clinically significant distress or impairment, and criteria C states that the disturbance is not better explained by another mental health disorder. So what is the major theme that separates, that distinguishes separation anxiety from other kinds of anxiety disorder? So this could be helpful while asking questions to your client or while reading a vignette that has kind of some of the symptoms that sound kind of very much either generalized anxiety disorder type or agoraphobia type or social anxiety type. So usually someone who has agoraphobia or social anxiety will not want to go out. They would like to stay in. They would avoid going out. When they think of going out in agoraphobia, they might feel physically ill. And thoughts and cognition usually in generalized anxieties all revolves around worry and something bad's gonna happen. So how can we separate this from the worry, the persistent distress arising from separation anxiety? One way to look at it is that the why behind the behavior. So asking the person or looking, reading for the why is that, is the fear, is the major theme that I will lose the loved one and then I will be alone? Is that the theme? If the person says that, yes, I don't want to leave because I don't like to be alone. When I'm alone, you know, something bad's gonna happen to this person. They're gonna die and then I'll be left alone. That is something like the theme or the fear behind the worry. Then probably all of those symptoms can be attributed to separation anxiety. I hope you learned something today from this video, and if you did, please consider liking the video and hitting the subscribe button. That helps me and encourages me to make more videos.